despite the fact that Joseph Prince is a false teacher, people would choose to go to his meetings, listen to his teachings, and believe his doctrine. You know why? Because the set moment has arrived. For the time will come when people will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myths. The frightening time has arrived when true teachers of the word would be resented and false teachers admired. The shocking moment has dawned when truth would be curtly rejected and error readily embraced. Joseph Prince's heresy has continued to flourish because people are hooked more to error than truth. Fulfilling what the Apostle Paul had written in 2 Timothy 4, 3-4. As Paul had correctly predicted what would happen in his day, the same thing is also happening today, where multitudes flock to listen with their itching ears to Joseph Prince, who will tell them what they want to hear. I read from the internet about one pastor who overheard a couple talking. "We love to attend this church because the preacher teaches the way we like to hear it." False prophets tell the people what they want to hear, not what they need to hear. In the same way, people listen to Joseph Prince's teachings because he teaches what their itching ears want to hear. The people love to hear with their itching ears what they want to hear when Joseph Prince tells them that every of their future sins has been forgiven by Jesus at the cross, without the need for confession and repentance. While it is true that the provision for the forgiveness of all our future sins have been accomplished at the cross, it is erroneous to teach that every future sins has already been forgiven without confession and repentance. The people love to hear with their itching ears what they want to hear when Joseph Prince tells them that repentance is only a change of mind. It is erroneous to say repentance involves only a change of mind. For repentance to be authentic, the change of mind must be backed up by our concrete actions of repentance, as it ought to affect our lives too. As I studied the text some time ago, I realized that in the context of 2 Timothy 4, 3-4, it is not the false prophets who lead the people astray per se. Instead, it is the people who have allowed themselves to be led astray. In a short text of a mere 2 verses, the word "they" was repeated twice, and the word "there" was repeated 3 times. The shocking thing is, it is the people who take the initiative to be deceived and led astray. It is the people who will not put up with sound doctrine. It is the people who will gather around them false teachers with messages that would suit their own desires. It is the people who will tell these false teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. It is the people who will turn their ears away from the truth and turn to heresies. The booming business of the cheap grace doctrine is not just because of the eloquence and charisma of Joseph Prince, but it is also because there is an ungodly demand or a ready market for it. Enticing wolves such as Joseph Prince, who plays the tune of the cheap grace doctrine that appeal to the flesh, have a great following, chiefly because there are consorting sheep who are willing to dance along with it. Sheep with itching ears who are willing buyers of false teachings are as culpable as the wolves who peddle them. Sheep with itching ears are as damnable as deceptive wolves. They are not being deceived. They choose to be deceived. No one needs to be deceived, and everyone can choose not to be deceived. And those who are deceived have chosen to be deceived. Sheep who dangerously and openly flirt with the seductive doctrines of the wolves would have no one to blame but themselves for their tragic destiny. The kind of false teachings that people are drawn to only reveal their true heart desires. If people are looking for an easy and comfortable Christianity, they would be drawn to Joseph Prince's cheap grace teachings that don't cost anything. If people have the greed to be very rich, prosperity preacher such as Joseph Prince would be intensely listened to and warmly embraced. If people are living in sin, preachers such as Joseph Prince, who sells the doctrine that all our future sins have been forgiven without the need for confession, would be applauded and idolized. Many people are captivated by Joseph Prince's teachings, not just because he is eloquent. The main reason is that Joseph Prince's teachings appeal to their fleshly desires, the fleshly desires of a no-need-to-do-anything faith, the fleshly desires of a no-price-to-be-paid for discipleship faith, the fleshly desires of a no-risk-at-all of losing my salvation faith. The key reason why the crowds are drawn to Joseph Prince's teachings is that his teachings are constantly targeted at the flesh. The fact that Joseph Prince has succeeded in packaging and presenting his grace teachings that are clearly of the flesh to sound like they are of the Spirit is the genius of it all. Feeding and pleasing the flesh with feel-good sermons must surely be the open secret to Joseph Prince's key to exponential church growth. And when your insatiable flesh is being repeatedly gratified, such teachings become almost irresistible. When the people are enchanted by teachings that please the flesh, they are gradually numb to the truth. And it would not be long before the truth is somewhat thrown out the window, because such fleshly desires are too alluring and overpowering. People will no longer put up with sound doctrine. They will turn their ears away from the truth, and they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. Note, it is the people themselves who initiated the whole process of being deceived by false teachers and have allowed themselves to be deceived. So, Joseph Prince cannot share the total blame, as it is the people themselves who are to be blamed too, as they choose to be deceived. And the tragedy is that both the deceiver who peddle false doctrine and those who choose to be deceived by heresies are headed towards destruction.